Among the many things that make the aquatic environment different is that underwater, animals don't tend to run away from us the way they do on land. In fact, so long as they can remain outside of arm's reach, most aquatic animals will be content to simply ignore us. Divers pose a vastly greater threat to underwater plants and animals than they do to us. As a result, we have an obligation to behave responsibly anytime we are underwater. This includes being aware of where our hands, legs, feet, fins, and body are at all times. Not stirring up silt or sediment. Suspended particle matter can make it difficult for animals such as coral polyps to breathe and feed. And making certain that you and your equipment avoid contact with the bottom at all times. This can cause extensive environmental damage. It's important to understand that the slightest touch on a coral polyp destroys the organism's protective membrane, causing permanent damage. This is why buoyancy control is such an important skill. Not only does your ability to control buoyancy make diving easier and safer, it helps you avoid damaging the fragile underwater environment. The rules and regulations governing scuba diving, the harvesting of aquatic animals, and interaction with marine mammals can vary from one location to the next. It's your responsibility to learn what these rules are and obey them, as well as to support local conservation efforts. When diving in a marine park or sanctuary, the local management agency will generally post its rules or require local dive operators to make you aware of them. At some destinations, dive operators are required to collect fees, which help support the local marine park or sanctuary. Remember, this money is being used to make your diving more enjoyable. If you have questions about the conservation rules that may apply in your area, just visit your local SDI dive center.